blinded with them as...
wasn't blinded, but there was no... It was just the way the pixels were in that particular film.
Yeah.
And it got to me. And then... also, the flashing when I was video chatting with a friend of mine.
Yeah.
The flashing from the phone.
Yeah, but to go on for very long. But to go on for very long, or yeah,
GP.
Yeah, but what's the GP say? What's the GP say to you?
To ring the epilepsy nurse.
Yeah.
And the epilepsy nurse, I left a message.
Yeah.
And the epilepsy nurse never got back to me.
Yeah.
So I don't have to try and ring her later again.
Yeah.
I already left the message, took the message already. Mm-hmm. I'm not leaving no one.
Yeah.
The clinic is probably closed anyway, you know?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
My doctor told me to bring her back tomorrow.
Do you not think that you might need to go for MRI to see what the problem is?
Yeah, they have to. I think they have to do something to check my brain waves or something.
They like might need to get a scan done, an MRI or something.
What happened to you, Tania? What happened to you?
Yeah, I used to have very, very severe flashes in my eyes, and since I had my medication done, I don't really get them anymore. As much as I used to.
You went for a test, didn't you?
I had an ECG done. Maybe you should get an ECG done and see what the problem is, Oshie. Maybe go for an ECG or go for an MRI. Maybe you should organise that to your doctor.
The doctor's frightened to have a seizure now.
Yeah.
During watching a film or something, you know.
Yeah. And maybe you shouldn't be watching too much TV. Maybe you shouldn't be use too much of your computer either, while your eyes are like that, you know.
Yeah. I have to stay away from
anything that's not too flashy images. Any flashy images on telly is not very good for people with epilepsy, you know.
Did you have this for long? Yeah, just recently. I used to be perfect before that.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe, don't you ring your doctor and make an appointment for a scan, an ECG or an MRI?
Well, I rang the epilepsy nurse.
Yeah.
So, I left a message.
Mm.
And my GP was talking to me as well. He said that if the epilepsy nurse doesn't get back to me, I left a message there.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't get back to me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm to... bring it back tomorrow. So I said I would bring it back tomorrow, but the
epilepsy
nurse hasn't rang me yet.
Yeah, but that's the only way that you find out what the problem is if you get a scan, Oshin. The only way that you find out what the problem is if you get a scan. You know? You there?
I know, they have to.
Yeah, they said that's the only way that you're going to find out what your problem is if you get a scan. Yeah. Just call your doctor tomorrow and see what he says. Just tell him what you're getting, the problem is. You're getting flashes in your eyes and see what they say. See what they can do for you. Maybe ask him, do you think I need to get a scan done? Do you think I need to get a scan done, an ECG, or what do I need to get done? Would I need to get my meds? Oh, well, I need to get my medication changed. Would you think you need to change your medication, Oshin? Do you think you might need to change your medications?
No, he doesn't know. It's only the consultant neurologist, Dr. Dom, that I think.
What meds?
He doesn't do that. He's not a neurologist.
Yeah. Yeah, but which meds are you on, Oisin? What meds do you take?
I take Lamictal.
Lamictal. Which dosage are you on?
I'm on, what was it now? 250
milligrams
at night.
Yeah.
And 200 in the morning.
Yeah. What else do you take?
I take Sonam as well.
Yeah, I've never heard of that one now.
Yeah.
And did you take anything at lunchtime?
No, I just take it morning and night.
Morning and night. Yeah. And how long since you took it, since you had a seizure then?
No. I mean, those flashing images, they're seizures. There's activity in my brain.
Yeah. Do you ever get headaches with them?
No, I don't, but I'm getting headaches every day now.
Every day?
The last couple of months.
Yeah.
I didn't care if someone said something to me, and I just say, yes. And I didn't really know what they said. I wasn't with it, like.
Yeah.
She wouldn't understand anyway, so don't say it to her until I find out what the doctors say first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not telling her now.
You're calling the doctor tomorrow, aren't you?
The doctor's going to bring me back tomorrow.
Yeah. Will he call to you tomorrow? Will you let me know how it goes?
I'll message Liam and say it to you.
I'd like to know what he says, okay? All right. I'd like to know what he says.
GP anyway tomorrow.
Yeah.
GP.
Yeah. I'd like to know how you get on. Okay. How it goes.
I'm very upset over the whole thing now.
Yeah, I'm sure you are. I'm sure you are very upset and very concerned. Yeah, so am I. Be concerned now too after hearing what you're saying. So.
It's not nice
to go through all that. No, it's not exactly very nice. No, it's quite scary.
Upsetting, yeah.
It's very upsetting. And I know exactly what you're going through. Yeah, I know exactly what you're going through. Because I went through all that myself. Well, the flashes are quite scary. The flashes are very, very scary. And they literally do blind you. You can barely see. You can barely see with them. Yeah, they literally do blind you, you know. They are quite scary.
You can't see it in their eyes, it's gone
and
come back.
You can't see a thing with them, no, they're so strong, yeah. They are quite scary, yeah. So when you get on to your doctor, will you keep you posted on how you get on?
I will.
Yeah.
Don't say it to Mama because I don't want to alarm her and kill. I find out exactly what's going on.
Yeah. But when you do know what's going on, will you please tell her? Because she has to know what's going on, Oisin. It's very important that she knows, okay?
Yeah, I'll say it to her when I find out, when I get the scar.
Yeah, yeah, because it's very, very important that she knows, you know? And, will you suggest about a scan? Because I think a scan is what you need to get done, and maybe an ECG or an MRI. I think out of those two scans, you probably need to see what the problem is, you know. An ECG may be a better scan, because they'll probably look right into your brain, and they'll probably find out whether you're getting these flashes in your eyes. You know?
Yeah, I know.
So tomorrow when you're talking to your doctor, maybe suggest it to him, maybe say, would I need to get an ECG done because I'm getting these flashes in my eyes, or what would I need to get done?
But I already said that to the doctor, he wanted to talk to the epilepsy nurse.
Mm.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. And then the epilepsy nurse says it to the epilepsy doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And then they make a decision then.
Mm.
Where to see me.
Yeah.
You know, get scans, all these things.
Yeah.
To ring me up for an appointment. I said, no, it's bothering me tongue as well, my time.
Yeah.
Bothering me tongue.
Yeah. Are you cold?
I
Yeah. All right. Tell me, call him tomorrow. I want you to tell Liam, and then Liam will tell me what's going on, okay? And I want to know everything. I want to know everything, okay? Yeah.
What time's your appointment tomorrow, Shane?
What time's your appointment at?
No, the doctor said if the clinic, if the epilepsy nurse doesn't ring me back today, I'm going to ring him tomorrow.
Right.
The epilepsy nurse hasn't rang me today.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
I have to message twice to him and all.
Yeah.
So, I have to ring my doctor tomorrow and say my GP tomorrow, so I don't know what he's going to do about it.
Yeah.
But all you can do is put me in contact with the neurologist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, just tell Liam and Liam will tell me what's going on. I want to know everything, all right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because it does sound very, very, very concerning, you know?
It's awful, it is.
How's your eyes now? Are you getting the flashes now?
No, because I have the phone down.
You have the phone down.
That's why you can't see his face.
Yeah. You have the phone down. Is he all right at the moment with the phone down? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Yeah. So it only happened if you put the phone up that you get the flashes.
It feels uncomfortable, you know. And I imagine the flashes. I imagine the phone being covered. And that's upsetting. So I don't know where the phone's really covered or where the images or flashes are, or where I'm imagining. So the whole thing is very upsetting, so I just have the phone down.
Yeah. So you're saying if you put the phone up, you'd get the flashes. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I got them before, so I don't want to take a gamble.
You don't want to get a gamble, yeah. And how much TV do you watch a day, Ushi?
Younger Phil.
I want a couple of hours of a good few hours over now, you know. But if those flashes come again, I'm just turning the TV off.
And you watched the match last night, and how was that when you watched the match?
It was grand. It was the particular film I watched the other night there.
Firefox.
The particular film I watched it, but whatever the pixels on the screen, whatever which way the flash was, it got to me.
Yeah.
Now, I changed the channel and I put on Father Ted.
And
that wasn't
affecting
me. So whatever it was, that film,
well, there's anything too jumpy or anything, there's any picture that's too flashy, has got anything to, yeah. If anything that's too flashy or anything too jumpy, anything picture that's too jumpy would be good for you to watch, you know? Yeah.
Pardon?
Is there any picture on TV that's too jumpy or too flashy? Has anybody got too flashy light, too flashy, you know, flashing images on screen? That wouldn't be good. Like, you know, say an entertainment show, like, say a certain night's takeaway, all that kind of shows, all those flashy lights, they wouldn't be good for you either. Anything with flashy lights or any jumpy images, any jumpy images wouldn't be good for you, you know?
I'm not really able to do much now, you know?
Yeah, and I wouldn't recommend you use too much of your computer either, or you know, playing video games. Too much video games about you either. No.
No, there's an epilepsy warning on PlayStation
4
as well.
Yeah.
An epilepsy warning.
I wouldn't recommend you go to any nightclubs. You know, because the straw lights and the straw lights wouldn't be good for your eyes either. The straw lights are not very good for people with epilepsy.
They could make you crazy.
Yeah, they cause seizures as well. You know, those lights at the discos they give you seizures as well. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So I wouldn't recommend watching any of the music stations on TV either, because a lot of those videos are very flashy.
I find when I get out going for a walk,
yeah,
meet my friends in the local shopping centre.
Yeah.
I'm okay.
A lot of fresh air is very good for your head. A lot of fresh air is very good for your head. If you have headaches, a lot of fresh air is very good for that.
Headaches every day.
Yeah. Yeah. I know, but fresh air is very good for that. Fresh air would help your head. Yeah.
I just take
Solvenine, because I'm working more. But about Nurofen? Don't you get Nurofen? That's probably the best one to get. Nurofen is probably the best for headaches. Get Nurofen, that's probably the best painkiller you can get. Buy Nurofen, that's the best one.
Right.
Yeah, you can get Nurofen. Yeah, and that's probably the best painkiller that you get. It's actually better than Panadol.
Is it better than Solvenine?
Yeah, it's not better than Solvenine and Panadol. Yeah. Nurofen.
Right.
Yeah. Extra strong. Get the extra strong ones. The extra strong.
Try them anyway.
Yeah. See how good they are. We're going to try.
You get extra strong. Get the extra strong ones. They're a lot better than the Panadol anyway. Not much better. Yeah. Because I tried them, because I use them and the pain is gone like in seconds, literally in seconds. Well, it'll be gone within an hour, within the hour, mainly within the hour, yeah. So they're literally very, very good. They're actually one of the best painkillers you can ever get, is Nurofen. Yeah. Alright, so we call your doctor and Liam will tell Liam everything and Liam will tell me what the story is and keep me posted, okay, and how you get on, alright?
Yeah.
You mind yourself and take it easy now. Don't be watching too much TV and no video games or anything like that, alright?
Right.
Mind yourself and take it easy now. Rest now and take it easy now, okay?
Alright, see you. You gotta go now. Come soon, alright?
Mind yourself. Take care.
Bye.
I was tired this morning from knocking around you at 9:30. I went to bed for an hour after
and
I was tired. Because I was up
late
last night.
But I wasn't
myself. Yeah.
Feeling
myself,
you know.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the floor anyway.
Okay, I'll talk to you soon.
Talk soon, right? Bye.
Could you take them bins out?
Bye.
Yeah, bye.
Could you take them bins out? Probably too early for that parcel. It's not 25. Would that be? Wouldn't be in there, so wouldn't. The parcel would be there, so it wouldn't. It's only 20 to 5 now. It's too early, isn't it?
Yeah.
Would it be too early? The parcel. 20 to 5. It's set by 10 to 5, isn't it? 10 to 5, 10 to 6.
10 to 5, 10 to 6. Yeah.
It's only 20. That's quite scary, isn't it?
Yeah.
I remember, like, when I had the baby bath, the flashes, do you remember?
Yeah.
Like, it's so strong, I could barely see anything. It's so strong, I could barely see.
Go ahead and then you're in.
With Biggie's estate, I got a story to tell as an intimate rendering of a man whose rapid ascent and tragic end has been at the center of rap lore for more than 20 years.
You told me it was working, I believe.
You want to do this? You need to commit to this? No, you can't do both.
You disrespected my house. That wasn't my son.
Biggie, I got a story to tell like other dogs. documentaries looks at the murder mystery that surrounds his death, but more importantly, it celebrates and focuses on his accomplishments and his great music legacy.
He blew up overnight. We have no origins for what rap planet this guy came from.
I'm Sean McSanchez with the Big Picture and Dose of Music Station, FM 104. Accessories like ropes and dining tables. Have a sky we'd like to create.